Hello student, in this video I will explain the chapter A Letter to God by G.L. Fuentes. First of all, I will explain about the author, then the summary of the chapter. So let's start. About the author, G.L. Fuentes was a Mexican novelist, poet and journalist. He was one of the leading chroniclers of the Mexican Revolution. He has written many books, including La Seringa, De Crestos, Claros, De Silva, and many more. He was awarded the National Prize of Art and Science in 1935. Now, about the lesson. In the chapter, you will get extreme faith in God may give you a ray of hope even in the darkest time. Now, the summary of the chapter. Let's see what happens in A Letter to God. The only house in the entire valley overlooked a field of ripe corn. Lencho, the owner of the house and field, had been looking at the sky all morning. He told his wife that it was going to rain. So, true to Lencho's prediction, big drops of rain began to fall. Lencho went outside to enjoy the rain. He felt that it wasn't rain, but 10 and 5 cent pieces. With satisfaction, he watched the rain saw his ripe corn field. Suddenly, a strong wind began to fall. Then, large hailstone began to fall. Lencho's happiness now turned to worry. He hoped the rain would stop soon. Otherwise, his crop would be destroyed. But the rain did not stop. It covered the house, the field, and the valley with a layer of hailstones. The harvest was completely destroyed. Lencho stood in the middle of his ruined field and thought that a plague of locusts would have been better than this. It was a sad night for the Lencho's family. However, they had one hope, God. That night, Lencho thought about God and his all-seeing ways. So, he decided to write a letter to God, asking for 100 pesos to sow his field as well as survive until next year. He went to the post office the next day to stamp and mail the letter. The postman, on seeing the letter, laughed and looked it to show it to his boss. The postmaster, a fat, cheerful man, laughed as well, but he admired Lencho's faith in God. Not wanting to disappoint Lencho, he decided to write an answer. He also realized that he would have to send some money along with the letter. So, he collected contribution from his employees and friends. He also denoted a part of his salary. However, he could only collect a little more than half the amount Lencho had asked for. He put the money in an envelope along with a letter marked God. On Sunday, Lencho returned to the post office. The postman handed him the letter. The postmaster, happy with his deed, watched from the office. Lencho was a man of faith, so he wasn't surprised to see the money. However, he was angry when counted the money. Immediately, he asked for ink and paper. He sat at the writing table and slowly wrote a letter. It looked like he was having trouble expressing his thought on paper. Finally, he finished the letter and dropped it in the mailbox. The postmaster immediately collected the letter and opened it. In the letter, Lencho had written that of the 100 pesos, only 70 pesos reached him. He needed 30 pesos more. But he asked God not send it through the post office. He believed people at the post office were thieves who stole his 30 pesos. So student, it was the summary of the chapter. I hope your concept must be clear now. If you have any problem related to this chapter, please write it in the comment box. Thank you.